बोलो हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू अनदर सेशन ऑफ कम्युनिटी हेल्थ एंड सोशल वर्क एंड यू आर वॉचिंग यूएन कॉलेज डिजिटल क्लास यूट्यूब चैनल. वी आर डिस्कसिंग ऑन न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम्स. इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड डिस्कस्ड ऑन व्हाट इज न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम, टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम, कॉज एंड प्रिवेंशन ऑफ न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम एंड ऑल्सो वी हैड डिस्कस्ड ऑन प्रोटीन एनर्जी माल न्यूट्रिशन एंड लो बर्थ वेट न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम व्हिच आर कमिंग अंडर न्यूट्रिशन न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम टाइप. एंड इन दिस क्लास नाउ वी विल डिस्कस ऑन सम अदर न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम्स व्हिच आर कमिंग अंडर न्यूट्रिशन न्यूट्रिशनल प्रॉब्लम. एंड इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द प्रॉब्लम फीचर जीरोफ्थाल्मिया, केराटोमलेशिया एंड वी विल डिस्कस ऑन न्यूट्रिशनल एनीमिया एंड वी विल डिस्कस ऑन कॉज एंड प्रिवेंशन ऑफ दिस डिजीजेस. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस ऑन जीरोफ्थाल्मिया. जीरोफ्थाल्मिया इज ए प्रोग्रेसिव आई डिजीज कॉज्ड बाय विटामिन ए डेफिशिएंसी. लैक ऑफ विटामिन ए कैन ड्राई आउट योर टियर डॉक्स एंड आईज. विटामिन ए डेफिशिएंसी और हाइपोविटामिनोसिस ए इज ए लैक ऑफ विटामिन ए इन ब्लड एंड टिश्यूज. इट इज द मोस्ट वाइड स्प्रेड एंड सीरियस न्यूट्रिशनल डिजॉर्डर. जीरोफ्थाल्मिया इज एन आई डिजीज व्हिच अकर्स ड्यू टू लैक ऑफ विटामिन ए. व्हेन ए पर्सन इज टेकिंग फूड एंड इन दिस फूड द पर्सन इज नॉट टेकिंग विटामिन ए देन द पर्सन विल फेस that is xerophthalmia problem. Lack of vitamin A, it can dry out our tears and ducts so that we are facing the problem that is xerophthalmia. And due to xerophthalmia, sometimes the person are facing blindness. So that we have to cure and we have to detect that problem from the preliminary stress. And we have to take that type of food in which we can get vitamin A, through which we can eradicate the problem xerophthalmia. Next, we will discuss on causes of xerophthalmia issue. Lack of vitamin A. Xerophthalmia issue occurs due to lack of vitamin A. It is an element of the protein that absorbs light in the receptors in retina. When the retina is not getting vitamin A, then the retina will fail to detect the light, so that xerophthalmia issue occurs. We have to take vitamin A in our food and we will get vitamin A from some specific foods like that is from dietary foods and from eggs, meats, poultry and fishery. So that we have to take animal foods through which we can get vitamin A sufficiently. If you are not taking that type of food, then we have to take some supplements from which we can get vitamin A, through which we can eradicate the problem that is xerophthalmia. Then we will discuss on prevention of xerophthalmia. Administering large doses of vitamin A orally on a periodic basis, regular and adequate intake of vitamin A, and fortification of certain food with vitamin A, sugar, salt, tea and skimmed milk. We have to take large doses of vitamin A in periodical basis through orally, through which we can get vitamin A in our food. Because the body will not create vitamin A own self. So that we have to take our food in which we can get vitamin A, and we have to take it periodically and regular basis to eradicate the problems or eradicate the issue which is related with our vision. Next we will discuss on keratomalacia problem. Keratomalacia is an eye condition in which the cornea, the clear front part of the eye, gets cloudy and softens. This eye disease often starts as xerophthalmia, which is severe dryness of the cornea and conjunctiva. The conjunctiva is the thin mucous membranes that lines the inside of your eyelid. and covers the front of your eyeball. If keratomalacia is not treated, the softening of your corneas can lead to infection, rupture and tissue changes that may result in blindness. Keratomalacia is also an eye disorder. It's also the disease which is related with eye. And this occurs at the result of xerophthalmia. When the person is facing xerophthalmia problem and this is not clear, at that time the person will face keratomalacia issue. And in keratomalacia, this also occurs blindness of a person. And in keratomalacia problem, it covers the eyeball of your eye so that the person will be unable to see. Then causes of keratomalacia. Keratomalacia is caused by a severe deficiency in vitamin A. There is not a medical consensus on whether the vitamin A deficiency is due to dietary deficiency or due to a metabolic inability to absorb the vitamin. Keratomalacia usually affects both eyes and is most commonly found in developing countries where the population has a low dietary intake of vitamin A or a protein and calorie deficiency. Keratomalacia is also known as xerotic keratosis and corneal melting. And the causes of the keratomalacia is as xerophthalmia, due to lack of vitamin A, the person is facing keratomalacia issue. So we have to take that type of food and take vitamin A so that we can cure the keratomalacia problem. There is not a medical consensus where we can get vitamin A. We have to maintain our balanced diet through which we can get vitamin A in our food. And we have to intake that type of food to eradicate the keratomalacia problem. Keratomalacia always affects the both eyes. And when the both eyes is going to blindness, then the problem is keratomalacia. And this xerophthalmia is the first stage before keratomalacia problem. In some of the developing countries, keratomalacia problem is a problem which because of this problem, some people are facing blindness issue. Then prevention of keratomalacia disease. To prevent keratomalacia, doctor will perform an eye examination and blood test to determine a vitamin A deficiency. The doctor has to test the blood and also the doctor can examine the eye of the patient, and through which the doctor can detect that problem. And from blood test, the doctor has to define the deficiency of vitamin A in a person's body. And next is electroretinography, a test that examines the light sensitive cells of the eye, can also be used to prevent keratomalacia. There is an other test that is electroretinography, through which the doctor can examine the light sensitive cell of the eye, through which the doctor can know about the light sensitive power of the person, and through which we can prevent the keratomalacia problem. In cases where the cornea has been sufficiently damaged, keratoplasty is recommended. Keratoplasty is a prevention which is surgical prevention, and in keratoplasty, the person has to operate that tissues, those tissues which are unable to see, or which tissues are restricting the vision power of the person. So we have to transplant new tissues against the tissues which are unable to see or which are incapable for vision. Then is nutritional anemia. Nutritional anemia refers to two types of anemia that can be directly attributed to nutritional disorders. One is iron deficiency anemia and other one is pernicious anemia. Nutritional anemia is caused by a lack of iron, protein, vitamin B12 and other vitamins and minerals that needed for the formation of hemoglobin. Nutritional anemia is two types. One is iron deficiency and another one is pernicious anemia. It causes due to nutritional disorder of a person. When the body is incapable or the body is not creating hemoglobin, then the person is facing nutritional anemia. And also that occurs due to deficiency of iron and folic acid in our body, and also due to lack of vitamin, which are required for a healthy person. When the person has lack of that type of nutrients, then the person will face that is nutritional anemia. Folic acid deficiency is a common association of nutritional anemia, and iron deficiency anemia is the most common nutritional disorder. These are some most common nutritional disorder. Next, we will discuss on vitamin deficiency anemia. Vitamin deficiency anemia usually happens when the body of a person is not able to intake sufficient folate, that is vitamin B12 or vitamin B9. It can be affect the bodily functions to a great extent. When the person has vitamin deficiency and when the person is not taking that type of food through which the person can get vitamin B12 and vitamin B9, then the person will face the problem, that is vitamin deficiency anemia. Due to vitamin deficiency, the person is facing nutritional disorder, which is known as nutritional anemia. And there is some signs who are facing nutritional anemia problem, or there is some symptoms due to vitamin deficiency disorder. And these symptoms are fatigue, shortness of breath, dizziness, pale or yellowish skin, irregular heartbeats, weight loss, numbness of tingling in your hands and feet, muscle weakness, personality changes, unsteady movements, mental confusion or forgetfulness. These are the symptoms of vitamin deficiency anemia. If a person has any problem, then the person has vitamin deficiency. Then iron deficiency anemia. Iron deficiency anemia happens to be one of the top contributors of diseases across the globe as per the World Health Organization, and the most common nutritional deficiency. Iron deficiency anemia is the most common deficiency in our country, and iron deficiency anemia occurs due to deficiency of iron in a human body. When the person is not taking iron related food or not taking supplements against iron related food, then the person will face the iron deficiency disorder or the iron deficiency anemia. And those who have iron deficiency anemia, then the person has some specific symptoms. Signs that a person is suffering with iron deficiency anemia are pale skin, lack of energy and tiredness, facing short breath, irregular heartbeats, headache, itchiness, ulcers in mouth, hair loss, depression and irregular menstruation in women. When any persons have this type of symptoms, then the person has iron deficiency anemia. Next, causes of nutritional anemia. Inadequate diet. When a person is taking inadequate diet, or when a person is not maintaining balanced diet, the person is not taking the food in which the person will get all the nutrients which are required or which are need for maintain a healthy life, then the person will face that is nutritional anemia. We have to take iron, we have to take protein, calorie in our food. When the person has iron disorder or when the person has lack of iron in her body, then the person will face न्यूट्रिशनल एनीमिया और न्यूट्रिशनल डिसऑर्डर। नेक्स्ट इज इनसफिशियंट इनटेक ऑफ आयरन। व्हेन ए पर्सन इज टेकिंग इनसफिशियंट आयरन देन द पर्सन हैज न्यूट्रिशनल एनीमिया प्रॉब्लम। नेक्स्ट इज प्रेगनेंसी। At the time of pregnancy, the person or the woman has importance of taking iron and folic acid in her food. When the mother or when the woman is not taking iron or folic acid or in type of medicine also, if the mother is not taking, then the pregnancy lady will face that is anemia problem. And the pregnant lady has to take iron and folic acid, because in hospitals there is a free distribution of iron and folic acid for young girls and also for the pregnant woman. So they have to take that in their food, through which they can prevent the nutritional anemia. Then is excessive menstrual bleeding. If a woman has excessive bleeding at the time of menstrual, then also the woman is facing anemia issue. When the woman has hemoglobin problem, or when the person has not limited or minimum hemoglobin, then the woman will face that type of problem. Next is hookworm infestation. Sometimes the person has infected by hookworm, so that the problem arises due to hookworm infestation, that is nutritional anemia. Next is malaria. When the person is suffering from malaria, or at the time of pregnancy the mother is facing malaria, then the baby has also faced the anemia problem due to lack of nutrients. Then close birth intervals. The parents and the mother and also the family members are not aware about birth intervals, and they are not aware about minimum time period or minimum gap between one child to second child. So that close birth interval is a major reason of anemia. And due to close birth intervals, the mother can take care of herself, and also the mother can take care of the child, so that the child and the mother both are facing anemia problem due to lack of nutrients. Next is gastrointestinal bleed. It is a symptom of a disorder in your digestive tract, and the blood often appears in stool or vomit, but is not always visible. Through it may cause the stool to look black or tarry. The level of bleeding can range from mild to severe and can be life threatening. It's also a life threatening cause of a anemia problem. Next we will discuss on risk factors. Infants and children have life risk for due to anemia, and at the time of infants and the childhood period, there is need of the sufficient nutrients through which they can fight against the anemia issue. And at the time of infancy, the food of the infant depends upon the mother's food and depends upon the mother's health. So the mothers has to take proper nutrients, has to take iron and protein in her food, so that the child or the infant can take that nutrients from the mother's food. So the infants and children can prevent, or the infants and children have risk in their life due to anemia. And next we will discuss on pregnant women. Sometimes the pregnant women have risk in their life due to lack of nutrition. If at the time of pregnancy the pregnant woman can take proper nutrients, then there is risk at the time of childbirth and at the time of maternity and after childbirth also. Due to lack of nutrients, the mothers are facing maternal mortality issues at the time of childbirth and also after childbirth. And the mother has risk in their life due to lack of nutrients and also due to anemia issues. नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस ऑन प्री मेनोपॉजल वुमेन. इट बिगिंस सेवरल इयर्स बिफोर मेनोपॉज एंड इट्स अ टाइम व्हेन द ओवरीज ग्रेजुअली बिगिन टू मेक लेस एस्ट्रोजेन एंड इट यूजुअली स्टार्ट्स इन वुमेन्स 40s बट कैन स्टार्ट इन देयर 30s और इवन अर्लियर. प्री मेनोपॉजल ऑलवेज अकर्स एट द time of 40 years of a woman and sometimes it starts at the age of 30 also. Next we will discuss on prevention of anemia. Consume a balanced healthy diet rich in iron. We have to consume healthy diet in which we have to take iron to prevent or to fight against anemia issue. Lessen the intake of tea or coffee for it makes it harder for the body to absorb iron. For absorb of iron to our body, there is need of less intake of tea and coffee. Next is enhance the intake of vitamin C for it may boost the absorption of iron. Through vitamin C, we can get vitamin and also we can get iron to our human body, and through vitamin C we can boost our immunization power and we can boost iron for absorption of our body, so that we have to intake vitamin C in our food. We can take vitamin C related foods like orange, lemon, from which we can get vitamin C. And if we are not taking vitamin C type of food, then we can intake supplements like vitamin C chewing tablets also to get vitamin C in our human body. Next is consume iron and folic acid supplements. If we are not taking that type of food through which we can get iron and folic acid, then we have to consume iron and folic acid supplements. Next is nutritional education and awareness. Simply, we are not aware about nutritional education, so we have need of nutritional education. In our nutritional education, we have to know about what is nutrition and why nutrition is important for our health and what we have to take and what we have not to take, what is right and what is wrong for our health, and what is the importance of nutrients which are required for our health, and in which age and for which person is which quantity of nutrients are needed, that is also important. In nutritional education, we can know about all the data of nutrition related. So there is importance of nutritional education through which we can aware about nutrition and we can assess our nutrition also, through which we can take balanced diet or we can maintain the proper nutrition chart, through which we can maintain a healthy life. Next is blood transfusion in severe cases of anemia. If some persons are severe cases due to anemia, then there is they can transfusion of blood to prevent the anemia issue. In this class, we had discussed about xerophthalmia issue and discussed about keratomalacia and also discussed about nutritional anemia. And xerophthalmia and keratomalacia, that type of disease which are related with eye disorder and also related with the visionary problem of a person. And nutritional anemia is a type of problem which is related with our anemic problem, and there is different types of symptoms in vitamin deficiency anemia and iron deficiency anemia. And also we had discussed about causes of xerophthalmia disorder and also discussed about the causes of keratomalacia and nutritional anemia, and discussed about prevention of these diseases, which will help us to know about nutritional problems or know about the nutritional disorders and how we can prevent from that disorder. In next class, we will discuss about some other major problems which are related with undernutrition type of nutritional problem. If there is any doubt or if there is any query, then you can ask me through comment box. I will try to solve your problem. Thank you. Keep watching. Have a great day.